Floyd Mayweather versus Tenshin Nasukawa. Now, what really happened in this fight? Or what do we think happened in this fight? Now, in this exhibition match, what you saw was Floyd Mayweather came out a lot more aggressive than usual. A lot more willing to trade shots with the smaller Tenshin Nasukawa. Nasukawa was doing what a smaller fighter should be doing. Looking for angles, don't confront the bigger man head on, and look to counter and look to move in and out quickly and consistently. Now, both being opposite stances, this gives the left hand of Nasukawa, which is probably his best punch, a much better opening on orthodox Floyd Mayweather. And as you know about Mayweather's career, he doesn't necessarily have a weakness against southpaws, but he can't really use that Philly shell style against southpaw fighters because the left hand is more open on it, and the Philly shell has that natural opening for a left straight. So Floyd took the textbook stance as usual and just walked forward, very similar to what he did to Conor McGregor, just walked forward, hands up, and just took the shots on the gloves. But Tenshin being the smaller fighter, of course, Floyd is going to try to probably finish it early, not trying to make this a longer fight. I mean, it's only a 3-round fight, so doesn't really matter at the end of the day, but trying to overpower the smaller fighter is the best way to go. Now, Floyd is really messing around, walking forward, laughing, smiling, and just pawing out at the smaller fighter until he got hit. So when he came forward and threw the right straight, Tenshin slipped on the outside of the punch and returned with his left straight, which caught Floyd clean. And then Floyd started walking down Tenshin a little bit more seriously, where Floyd Mayweather started to utilize his long left hook. He would throw it and hop behind it instead of taking the outside foot advantage. He would throw it as he's hopping, and he would step further to create momentum for his right hook to the body. And why would this combination work? When someone throws a left hook, they usually want to lean away from it naturally. They will try to block it, of course, but whenever they move back on a left hook, they usually lean back and they expose the body. Floyd getting all that momentum forward and really stepping in is going to close in on the body. But Tenshin is extremely quick. He never really leaned from the punches. He is a kickboxer. And leaning in kickboxing isn't as utilized as it is in boxing because there's kicks involved. And if you lean one direction, you can get head kicked. And if you lean back, your legs are exposed to leg kicks. So the natural reaction of Tenshin from the kickboxing experience, he's just going to cover up and use the speed of his feet to move away. He missed once doing this. And the reason why the left hook isn't really landing on Tenshin is because Tenshin's keeping his right hand down the center. Whenever Floyd goes for the left hook, it's always getting blocked by the shoulder. And even if the fist goes all the way across, over the shoulder, the impact is decreasing so much. The power is decreasing. It's getting stopped at the shoulder. It's not going to deliver that much power onto Nasukawa. And then the second time Floyd went with this combination, raises like the hair of Tenshin. As Tenshin's doing the same thing, puts his right hand down the middle, blocking the punch. The punch never finds his target. Tenshin does a good job of lowering his chin behind the shoulder. And then Floyd does it again. He steps forward. A lot of leverage and a lot of momentum in this right hook to the body. It's very hard to see from the camera angles. Actually, a lot of this stuff is hard to see from the camera angles, but it seems like Floyd steps on the back foot of Tenshin as Tenshin is moving his foot back to get away from Floyd. So Floyd, with his left foot getting the outside foot advantage and stepping far for his right hand, steps on the shoe of Tenshin, and Tenshin falls back afterward. And Floyd goes for the right hook to the body again, and it looks like it misses. And for some reason, Tenshin tripped. He was falling because he tripped in the first place. And then Tenshin trying to get up. Okay, it looks a little bit strange. I'll talk about it a little later. But why is the ref counting? Tenshin didn't really get hit. He got tripped in the first place. The ref shouldn't be given a count here. It's a little bit strange. I don't know what the ref was doing there. And Floyd just continued with the left hooks and looking for his right hand behind them. And it got to the point where Floyd was able to get up in front of Tenshin again as he put his gloves on top of Tenshin's and then started ripping the uppercut to the body, created space with his left arm to fit in his right hand again. Remember, these are boxing gloves. They're going to need a little bit more space to land in the inside. And Tenshin starts pushing away with his right hand, but his left hand is still up. But Floyd is still able to catch Tenshin behind the glove. And this looks like the biggest punch of the entire fight from Floyd. Now, the reaction to the punch again looks a little bit strange because when Floyd connects, look at the way his punch is moving and look at how Tenshin's head moves from the force of Floyd's punch. It's moving from right to left, kind of, right? Tenshin's head is kind of dipped to his left and it gets pushed up toward his right. But then his head snaps back. Doesn't look like a natural reaction. If someone gives you a shovel hook as you're dipping your head to the left and it catches you toward the temple, the reaction shouldn't be like you got hit by a jab or hit by a straight right hand. You know what I'm saying? The push of a punch coming up at that angle, an arc, shouldn't send a guy's head straight back. Now, this can be the reaction of Tenshin. Maybe he got rocked that badly. Maybe he just lost his senses right there and then. But he did try to reach for the ropes and he kind of flopped over. Right, he kind of flipped, rotated as he hit the ground. So, I don't know, it looks a little bit iffy to me. But Tenshin, after that, he started throwing bombs at Floyd. His punches look legitimate. trying to knock off Floyd Mayweather. His left hand's digging all the way through, but Floyd has a really tight guard. He's not going to get hit by these big overhands, these big left looping punches. He'll duck a little bit. He'll slide to the right just enough. And then we look at the last knockdown, and you see Floyd Mayweather smiling at Tenshin Nasukawa. They both go at each other. Nasukawa comes in with a jab while Floyd comes with a left hook. The jab misses as Floyd connects with the left hook. It comes right over the shoulder, but Tenshin was leaning into the left hook. And it looks like it lands toward the ear, a little bit behind the ear, above the ear, around that area. And this potentially could have knocked off the equilibrium. And Tenshin tries to follow up with the left straight, and he gets knocked off balance, and the fight eventually gets finished because of this. Now, this 100% could be a knockdown. Whether Tenshin milked it, whether he over-exaggerated it, this can knock down someone 100%. The way Tenshin fell is a little bit strange, though, I have to admit. He did fall, which did look real. You actually do see him flexing a little bit as the left hand goes away. But as he fell, he tried to get his balance again, and then he kind of like hops back again and falls again. It's a little bit strange of a reaction for me. Whenever I see a fighter get the equilibrium knocked off, they never really react in this manner. They usually just drop, such as when Deontay Wilder landed that right hand behind the ear of Tyson Fury. Did Fury act in any kind of manner like this? No. When Conor McGregor landed his punch behind the ear on Dustin Poirier, did he react in this manner? He did not. They usually just fell, and they couldn't really stand up again. They weren't completely out of it, but they had no whereabouts of even trying to get up. This, I think, is a little bit up for debate. I think this is the most controversial one. I believe this is the most believable knockdown, of course, but the shots from Floyd Mayweather, yes, I believe Floyd hits harder, or at least, should I say, punches harder than anybody Tenshin's ever fought before. The impact that it seems to be showing here seems a bit much. The first fall when he tripped and the right hook missed the body, and Tenshin fell to his back and almost looked like he was getting cradled by a wrestler, and then flopped over to his belly like he's really hurt or he's struggling to get back up, again, seems a little bit strange. The second knockdown looks the most genuine because the punch did connect and it did look like a meaningful punch. Again, the trajectory, I guess you would say, or the arc of the punch and the reaction from Tenshin's head doesn't seem to be logical or natural unless he was completely out of it at that point where he's falling back. But when he was falling, he was reaching for the ropes and he was turning. He was rotating, again, back to his belly. And it looked like he was really struggling getting up. Now, I see a lot of people saying out there that this was fixed. The falls look fake. It looked theatrical. Tenshin Nasukawa really was milking it. I heard some people saying that he was like some of those really bad actors back in those martial arts movies. Whenever they fell, they really exaggerated it. And this is making a lot of people think that Tenshin Nasukawa is some young, fragile, weak, small fighter who this is the first time he's ever fought someone this powerful or someone this formidable in his career, and he's just not ready for it. Again, in a boxing match, he would never be Floyd Mayweather, I believe. But he's still getting punched by bigger gloves from a guy who's not known for his power. Again, I do think that Floyd might hit harder than anybody Tenshin's ever fought before, but he has fought guys like Kyoji Horiguchi, who has no laughing matter in his punches, with 4-ounce gloves, and he took all of his shots. Now, in my opinion, this does not look real to me. Some of the punches and some of the commitment, especially from Nasukawa, looked real. There were some punches he was really digging in on. But he's a smaller fighter, and Floyd's defense is impeccable. But Floyd's shots, they looked good as well. They looked meaningful. But the reactions of Tenshin, every time he got hit, he pretty much went on one knee. Or not even one knee, he fell to his back. Like, he got blown away from these shots. The reactions, in my opinion, do not look real. Maybe I'm wrong, it's just my opinion, but some of those falls looked a bit exaggerated. That's just my opinion. I'm wondering if anybody has an argument on the other side. Leave it in the comments below. And I've seen two arguments already. I've seen that Floyd Mayweather is the bigger man, so of course he's gonna hurt Tenshin Nasukawa whenever he hits him. Yes, he is the bigger fighter. But look at their weight. Tenshin was 137, Floyd was 147. They're about 10 pounds apart. Maybe they changed weight by the time the fight happened. So Floyd maybe was around 150, 152-ish, somewhere around there. Tenshin probably got up to maybe 140 or something, or just walked around 137. Anyway, the most I would give the difference in weight would probably be like 18 pounds and no more. That's just being generous to that argument. But we have seen bigger differences in fights before where the smaller fighter did get hit and didn't get blown away like they got hit by a hurricane or something. We've seen BJ Penn versus Lyoto Machida, which was a huge size discrepancy, and BJ Penn got hit and he took everything from Lyoto, who is known to knock people out, and a much, much bigger man. Where Lyoto fights at 185 now, BJ Penn went down to 145 at a couple points in his career, and fights usually at 155. Lyoto actually fought most of his fights at 205. We've seen Melvin Manuel fight Mark Hunt. We've seen Gegard Mousasi versus Mark Hunt. We've seen Frankie Edgar become the champion at 155, where he cut no weight, and he was fighting guys who now fight at 170, and now he fights at 145. And we've seen bigger size discrepancies. And we know about Frankie Edgar. He's been hit by some of the biggest punchers, and he's been hit by some big shots from big guys, and he has never been knocked out in 155. But all of a sudden, Tenshin's too small to fight Floyd Mayweather. I don't see how that argument holds ground, and especially the way Tenshin was getting hit. And then I see another argument that, why would Ryzen have their fighter lose? I don't know. To be honest, I have no idea. But I would ask, but why would this be an exhibition then? So does it really matter if he loses? And does it really matter if he loses a boxing match? I don't know. I'm not saying it's fixed. I'm not saying anybody did anything. I'm just saying the exchanges look weird. The falls look weird. The knockdowns look weird. The punches that knock down Tenshin look weird. That's all I'm saying. But yeah, strange fight. So yeah, guys, that's the end of the breakdown. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And if you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you enjoyed my content, make sure to subscribe. For my next video is going to be the podcast, so that's going to come out later this week. And again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.